everybody. Oh, where's my microphone? Am I on this one?
No.
There we go.
Rude.
I was going to do this as a little sound bit.
Oh, I see.
Yeah.
Segway.
Well, we say hello to everybody.
Segway.
Yeah.
That was
so smooth.
I didn't even know that was. I thought I didn't know we'd started.
Just nodded off.
Absolutely. Yes. Quite. A very good afternoon, everyone.
Hi, everybody.
Welcome to our wonderful live stream.
Indeed. My name's Trevor. And this is my colleague Tom.
Bear with.
If we're on the other camera.
Hello, everyone.
Who will appear.
Bit slow there. Let me just do that. That's better. Yes. I like all this, all the angles where we can see the, and then we can see all the stuff behind it.
Yeah, it's quite cool.
It's nice, isn't it? Yes. And welcome to our weekly live stream here at
our regular Tuesday slot at 3 o'clock, which I think now everybody has got the hang of.
The All Brand Show.
Yes, we haven't had any more phone calls on Friday saying, where are you? Every Tuesday at 3 o'clock. And presenting a different instrument every week.
Indeed.
From our wonderful store in Great Yarmouth, because we are beaming live from Allen's Music Centre.
Beaming.
In Marketgate Shopping Centre in Great Yarmouth. Yes. Where it is raining and windy, and I'm sure on the chat everybody's going to tell us that it's windy and raining everywhere else.
Yes, Alan in Leeds, I'm bearing with him, yes. But today though, I mean,
it's a very exciting day today, because...
I'm going to give a short look at this, so there we go.
Let's do that. Amazing, design of the OAX900.
Yes.
Which is a model that we teased way back at Peterborough.
Yes.
We had some pictures come through from Ulrich showing us this new design. And now we've finally got our first one here.
Yes.
This is waiting to go to its new owner.
I was going to say, we've got it for a very short space of time.
Who has been very, very kind and allow us to use it on this presentation. And it is absolutely gorgeous.
It is.
I can't stop myself stroking the bench. I like stroking
the bench. The thing is, because even the bench, because it is obviously very much a design change, but the bench is lovely because it's got these lovely accents, and the bench has actually got solid sides.
So kind of more of a retro kind of design, because it used to be in the day of the old sort of Wersi Helios and Saturn and Galaxy that the console of the organ was held up on these wonderful pillars, and that's what we have now. And it kind of just it really changes the feel and the look of the instrument. It's just gorgeous. And so I thought I would open up there. We have all the time in the world.
Which we don't.
Because we don't. this was, I've got the music up here for it, this was the winner of our poll on Patreon, where we asked our members what was their favourite Bond theme. And this one came out as number one. We have All the Time in the World.
Beautiful song. One of the last things recorded by Louis Armstrong.
Yeah.
Just before he passed away.
Absolutely gorgeous melody. And actually, that's one of the things I did like about the score for the new Bond movie, is they actually had little bits of this in there with
them. Yeah, really nice. Lovely.
Just that little refrain is just lovely. And that bit at the end where you just had the flugelhorn.
I think in the film it does go together.
Yeah, at the same time, but I've got a third hand. Well, I have now.
There we go.
A live duet.
Another reason to buy this organ.
If you have a phantom hand coming. if anybody's watched that new thing on Netflix with The Thing.
Wednesday. Brilliant,
absolutely
it?
Brilliant. And they, if anybody's familiar with the Addams Family, but they have a character that is a disembodied hand.
That's right, yeah.
Maybe we'll start selling a disembodied hand to come and play the extra bit for you.
Absolutely. Now thing.
Do you know when they filmed that, they actually had a live actor doing that?
Yes, yeah.
And then they CGI'd out his body rather than having a CGI hand.
Yeah.
Which was brilliant.
Absolutely
so the hand
incredible.
Was actually acting. Yeah. Anyway,
we better say some hellos.
Indeed, yes.
Yes, and of course we'll be answering any questions about the OAX900. Anyway, so we've got Erdie.
Hi, Ernie.
In
Cedar Falls.
Cedar Falls.
Hey.
Peter Steen. It's certainly a day to stay indoors and enjoy the music. We've got possibly a new person, Vivian Sadler.
Uh-huh.
Hello, Vivian.
Hello, Vivian.
Sure does. Peter's dull day, but know the music we will hear will be great. Uh-huh. Absolutely. Alf Smith says, Trevor and Tom, looking forward to showing of my Wersi 900.
Bit of a giveaway, that, isn't it?
Yeah, I wonder who this is going to, yes. Yes, thank you, Alf. Yes.
It does look fantastic.
How many?
Incidentally, this was ordered in this colour specially because that's one of the things that Wersi are able to do. They can do these custom colour schemes. So it is in this. Oh, blimey.
Someone ordering one as we speak. Yes.
So it's in this custom red finish, which is absolutely gorgeous. But you can get this organ in the standard Wersi black, the standard Wersi white, or pearlescent white.
Yes.
And the metallic black, I should say. But also, you can choose your own colour. So if you wanted a green one or a yellow one,
or an orange one.
Indeed. But I think it looks particularly striking in this gorgeous red.
Absolutely, it really does look fantastic. Steve Homan says, good afternoon everyone, on this damp day, looking forward to the demo of the new 900. Yeah. David in Penzance, he's feeling much better, and hope Tam is as well. Sorry to hear that Sybil has been in the wars.
Yeah, poor old cat.
We'll catch up on that. Douglas Watts said something, then took it back. Andy Pruss says, welcome from Germany. Hello Andy.
Hi, Andy.
Oh, and then Douglas Watts has said, afternoon all, what a miserable day weather-wise. If I have a present already saved... Oh, no, that's a question. We have a Wersi question.
Oh.
Well done, Douglas. Keep that there.
I was going to stop. Are we going to ask a question or will you come back?
Oh, we'll come back to it. We'll segue around there. Keith Rose. Hello, Keith. And everyone in the room, looking forward to seeing and hearing the new Wersi 900. Alan Robinson, greetings from a very wet Leeds. Told you. Peter Brown, new year, new demo. Yes.
Yeah.
Rover Leff, great fun. Leaf in Sweden is with you.
Yeah, wow. Yeah. That's incredible. Actually, is this our first video of 2023, isn't it?
No.
Oh, no, it isn't. We did one last week.
I do remember, I played the organ.
I didn't call it the 23.
No. We time travelled, didn't we? Yes. Boom, boom. James Parrott. Hello, James. I went and saw James. Did the weekly shop this morning. Got very wet. Back home to enjoy my Ringway RS760.
Lovely.
Really enjoying getting to know it.
Excellent.
Do you sit there sort of sipping a brandy? Hey, how are you? Well done, James. That's great for you. Graham Williams. Hello, Graham. Paddington has put his request for Marmalade in for October. Do you know, Graham, we had a very large animal
beautiful
visit the
dog,
store.
Yeah.
Yeah, big dog. And he's called Paddington.
Yeah. Don't ask me what kind. I have no idea.
It was like the waffle dog, but twice the size.
Waffle dog,
Robert Burgess, greetings all. Have to go soon, but we'll catch up on the broadcast on Patreon later. Any news on the new Wersi version update? In a word, no. But someone did mention that Ulrich had possibly said January.
It's the thing with these Wersi owners, they're getting a bit greedy, aren't they?
They are.
I mean, we have all these fantastic updates. Well, Ulrich works so hard.
Tappity-tappity-tapp.
I'm working hard. But yes, we are very lucky that he comes out periodically with these fantastic updates to give us all these new things to play.
He certainly does. Babs and Phil Wallace, hello everyone.
Hi, Babs,
nice to be
everybody.
Back with Alan's Online. Happy New Year to everyone and those we haven't said already too. Wayne Lux, MW from Germany. Norman's on. Norman and Dawn, all the time in the world, absolutely beautiful.
That is a lovely
and
song.
Send their best wishes. And Albert Roland. Hello all from the south of France. Bonjour. Ooh. Albert, ça va?
Ça va, oui, ça va, merci.
Ça va. Wayne says, nice socks, Trevor.
These are my Christmas socks. These are I don't know if there were any of the cameras.
Let me go for the side cam.
So these are my Power Ranger socks.
Are they?
So today I'm the Black Power Ranger.
Excellent. Do you know, I was watching the Toys That Made Us on Netflix, and they do a whole documentary about, and the Power Rangers one, that was just, forget it. Absolutely nuts how that went. Because I was a kid when it was going. Never was into Power Rangers. My mum didn't like it.
No, Isaac was obsessed with them. Yeah.
Yeah, there you go. Norman is asking, what price is the new model?
Depends on the colour.
It does, but we'll come back to that in a moment. But that's a very good question, Norman. Excellent, if I might say so. Lawrence Easdale. Lawrence wants to order your new Patreon stick.
I've sent it. It's in the post.
Oh, Lawrence, it's in the post. I don't need to call you back. It's in the post. There you go. From a wet, dull Northampton. Douglas Watts, another question. Andy Pruss. Dan Tabor from Vermont. Bright and sunny here, but cold. Hello, Dan. Alan Michael Robert Sleep.
Says, so I was talking to Mr.
That's right, Yeah. I've heard of a second-hand Wersi. Don't quite know what that means. Maybe you could elaborate there, Alan. Anyway, yeah. But well done. We obviously do pre-owned Wersis from. Yeah. Well, we have that. Max Green. He says reminiscent also of an earlier Boehm design. Yes, they used to do gold pillars. Yeah. Yeah. So very much a German design, really. Philip Russell. Good afternoon from Hemel Hempstead. When can I have mine? Oh no, it doesn't say that. Max Green is our. Oh, another question. Peter Smith says, "How is Sybil progressing?" We'll do that in a minute. Simon Brown, Peter Smith, Keith Darville, and Ken D. Actually, we've got several questions, Trevor.
Wow.
I'm going to backtrack because I can't look at the camera and do two things at once. Yes, so that's nice. Do you know, I think I'm going to just tweak one of the cameras, Trevor, while you're playing.
I can play.
You play, and we'll enjoy that lovely song. That's better. That's better. I like it now. Lovely. Very good. Well, that's lovely to see everyone on there.
Absolutely, yeah.
And you know, I this is quite amazing. We have currently 112 people.
Wow.
So that's our highest number to date.
Thank you, everybody.
Yes.
Click the like button. Click subscribe.
Yes. Send us something on PayPal. No. Anyway. Right. I'll let Trevor finish.
So this was the second favourite.
Was it?
Yeah.
Lovely.
The hand again.
Maybe that could be a duet concert at Peterborough.
Just have your hand come in. Bond thing going on there.
Like it. That's some love. That's the mandolin, isn't it?
Yeah.
Oh, a bit of zoning there. Clever.
Oh, very dramatic.
Lovely.
Hey.
Very nice.
Always like a nice bit of Bond.
Oh,
I won't play it, but can you guess what number three was?
Unibond.
Yes.
I would say Goldfinger.
Nope.
Okay.
Yep. Give you a clue.
Ah, that one. Living That Die. Very nice. Very nice. Excellent stuff.
Right, questions.
So,
questions. Far away.
Well, I think Andy in Germany has answered Douglas Watts's question for him. Maybe we need Andy on here as a moderator. Yeah.
Are you going to change your camera?
Yeah. Well, I'll do what I've done though. Look at that lovely red. It's gorgeous. And we're back.
Yeah.
Right. Okay. So Douglas said, "Afternoon all. What a miserable." Blah, blah, blah. If you have a preset saved, can then a MIDI file to that preset? So I think what he means is, can we link a MIDI file to a preset?
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah, quite happily.
Yeah.
Because the way MIDI files are played on the Wersi is they come out of the accompaniment section.
They do.
And so all songs are played from over here. Mm. So the same way as when you save a registration, you can save which style goes with it.
Mm-hmm.
If you've got the MIDI file copied in the organ, that's the easiest way of doing it, because
you've
got to remember to put it in the thing.
Yeah.
But if you've got the MIDI file in the organ, then yes, when you just select that preset, select the MIDI file to go with it. I haven't got any MIDI files with me, I don't think.
No, sadly not.
And then you can resave that preset. And when you save it, make sure it remembers what you're doing with the accompaniment, and
that's
it
right.
will remember your MIDI file with it.
I was
it.
Just trying to work out why this bench was so uncomfortable, and I realised I wasn't actually sitting on it properly.
Okay.
That does help.
It's only, 40 years, and you've finally learned how to sit on the
kind of
bench.
Yes, quite. Because when you save a or make a recording, it actually goes into the accompaniment sort of section of the
organ. So if you do, I mean, if it, we've done videos on this where if you make an audio recording, for example, they're, again, they're playback from the accompaniment section.
That's so right,
same, same kind of tone generator area of the organ that plays the styles will play back your MIDI files and your audio files. Yeah. And incidentally, for anybody that's been confused when they've upgraded to 2.9,
Yes, the old
the CD player has vanished. Yeah. The CD player now appears in the audio button on the audio screen.
That's it.
Which we haven't got a camera on at the moment because we've got a camera looking
at the recording. But it's basically, I think the thinking is that a WAV file, a MIDI file, a style, a CD, they can all be forms of accompaniment. So hence they all go into that
And the
same
volume
thing.
Of them is controlled by the song volume at the end.
It is. Yes. Yes, master overlaying. So yes, Douglas, so yes, you can.
So the answer is a big yes.
Yes, absolutely. And Andy Pross confirms that.
Oh, there we go.
Which he goes, which is all good stuff. So Robert Burgess asks, is there any news of the Wersi version update at some point soon?
Ulrich doesn't really commit himself to schedules and release dates, so we don't really get much warning in advance.
No, but I think because he releases the beta copy to dealers to test it, and then of course, as you know, in the field, you can only test so much in a programming section a setup. So I think he's obviously doing different things. But yes, but lots of things to come in that, and of course, exciting things for future updates.
We have a little sneak preview because he bought a version.
We saw we did a beta copy, didn't we? Yeah.
And we did a little video on Patreon on it. And there were things like being able to create your own one-touch settings, which is a brilliant idea. The fact that you could get rid of the bass box down here, because for anyone who doesn't play the pedals, it's kind of irrelevant as well. So you could make the screen bigger, showing you more of the accompaniment section. So there were some interesting
Absolutely.
Ideas.
Absolutely, yes. Now, a lot of people saying they like the design. It's very reminiscent of the retro days of the German.
I love it. I really do. Yeah. I'm sitting here just giddy with it.
And I think it's nice now because, as Trevor says, we've got the option of the standard black and white. The 500 to 800 models are now available in an optional wood veneer finish. And as Trevor said, we can, for a little extra, small extra premium, you can have red and literally pretty much if you have a Pantone colour, they can more or less do it, can't they?
Yeah, well, I think this was originally an Audi colour. That's what a lot, you know, you literally could take a colour sample from anywhere and we send it over to them and then match it
I think it was either Wersi or Boehm or probably both of them, but there was a thing in the 80s of the crystal organs.
The see-through
ones, yes. Maybe not. So
how much that would cost.
Oh, yeah.
At least you know if you left a screwdriver inside it. If you were
Absolutely. Max Green has asked, what does open art mean? Or what is open art? That's quite a long historical answer. But
well, essentially, it's the software that runs the organ.
Yeah.
Because all organs essentially do have a program in them that is making them run as an organ. So be it a Genos keyboard, a Ringway Maestro, a Lowry, there is a program in the background that runs and operates the organ. And so Wersi, because obviously they're using a computer, so it's a bit more kind of obvious that it's running a computer program. And so Ulrich likes to obviously give that program a name. So it's called the OAX system. And so the X is the current generation. Yep. Previous to this, there was the OAS system, which ran on Windows XP. And that was a very, very different concept. It works in a very, very different way. Yep. It didn't use a touch screen in the same way. It was, and to be honest, it was a bit muddled in terms of the operation of it. With the OAX system and the introduction of Windows 10 and having this big interactive touchscreen, this was the first instrument that introduced the idea that you can drag and move things around. Rather than the screen just being a touchscreen where you tap it once.
It's more of a tablet style.
You're able to move things around and you have this dynamic control over the screen. And that's really transformed the operation of it. So there is very little in terms of the operation that's similar between the different OAS instruments. A lot of the sound they carried over, and behind the scenes I'm sure some of the software was carried over, but the actual interface that we use here in front of us is completely different.
It is very different.
And is 100 times easier to use.
And of course it is making, because now the modern organs all run on 64 bits, they've got more memory, faster processors. In fact, on the OAS thing, they had to load each portion of the software, and you used to watch it on the screen, didn't you?
Each module you used to load in individually.
This is a little bit more,
of course, you were limited to three voices on the upper keyboard unless you spent a lot of money and had
the Selector Plus,
and then you could have four voices in the upper keyboard. Of course, with this dynamic system, and this is one of the things I love when I'm putting registrations together. You know, when we were doing those James Bond registrations and things with the strings and From Russia With Love.
Lovely.
Some of those registrations, we were mixing four, five, six different sounds together to get that big sound.
Big wall of sound.
And that's the thing that's so powerful about the Wersis, is that you can mix all these instruments together. So in one of those registrations there, from the Russia With Love one, just on the lower manual, we've got three different voices mixed together, and we can play them individually. So you've got things like the tremolo strings, and of course, what tremolo strings are doing are giving you that feeling of being a bit on edge. You know, they sound very dramatic.
I like that.
And then we're bringing in the mandolin orchestra, which in my mind, I know this is probably completely wrong, it sounds a bit Russian when it's like that.
Eastern.
And then we mix and choir on top of that. So you get this lovely big sound. And then on the upper keyboard, I've got two different string sounds mixed together. A dulcimer and a balalaika are doing a tremolo.
Nice.
So you get this big sound. When you put that all together with the rhythm, I mean, it's a... Better if I press the button.
Yes.
And when you're putting all these sounds together...
And the reverb DSP there is phenomenal. Yeah, lovely.
And when you're putting all these sounds together, you're able to adjust all of them. So it's very easy when you've got a voice there to add more reverb to it, add sustain to it. And also, one of the things I love doing is moving sounds left and right and generating what I would call a sound field. So you've got some sounds coming from the left-hand side, some sounds coming from the right. So when I was mixing those voices together on the upper keyboard, see, we took some strings here, played deep strings, and then we mix them with the high string. So when you put them together, you get that. It's a lovely big sound. And then we took the dulcimer, and then the balalaika.
That's a lovely tone.
And then you put all of that together, you get that. Amazing sound. And of course, we've got all of that going on, all those voices, and we've still got another seven that we could add in if we wanted to. So we've got basically unlimited polyphony, as many voices as you want. So there's no limitation on combining things together. I just noticed, actually, in the next registration, I had even more. So we have the choir in there as well. And it's just such a big, big sound.
Absolutely.
And the same left hand there, we added the brass in there. So you can build up registrations very, very easily, because if anybody's never tried the Wersi before, you have this idea of having a sound pool where all your voices come from.
Yes.
And you literally just pick up a voice from that sound pool and you drop it wherever you want it to go.
That's right.
So if you want to add it to the pedals, if you want another voice on the pedals, I've already got two down there, but if I wanted another one, I could just drag it down there. And I've now got three voices down on the pedals, and I can select that sound block. Can be any sound in the organ. There's no limitation that there's an upper keyboard section or lower section or pedal section. They are just voices, and you can allocate them wherever you want. And if you find a sound that you really like, and you've got it on the lower manual, so I've got this brass down here, and I think, actually, I would want that on the upper
pedals,
keyboard, on the upper keyboard, or even on the pedals. I can just pick it up and just drag it to the upper keyboard, and now it's up here. With everything else being very, very noisy.
And of course, the thing to remember there is that when you move the voice, it retains all of the parameters,
the characteristics that you've applied. You're made to it.
Because I remember years ago, if you had a sound on one keyboard, you had to sit there and
write reproduce down the vibrato, it, yeah, the octave, my goodness.
To try and reproduce it
very,
on the other keyboard.
Very important question from Peter Smith.
Yeah.
How is Sybil progressing? It's very appropriate.
She's doing
there.
Incredibly well.
Excellent.
I mean, you know, this thing about how resilient cats are and animals in general, considering what she went through, and she was, I don't want to go into graphic detail, but she was very, very badly injured, and she was in surgery for about 3 hours. And she's now sitting up in her cage, because she's got to be stuck in a cage for 6 weeks, purring and eating and drinking and basically being herself. I mean, obviously her legs are very sore, but she's already being very vocal about her dislike for being in the cage. So we come down in the morning, she's meow, 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 meow.
But that's good, yeah. But,
yes,
but so good to hear she's doing so well.
Yeah. And thank you, everybody, for all your lovely messages. I know it's a funny thing. I put the pictures up there because I knew everybody just care about us so much. And it's lovely to hear all lovely well wishes. Thank you.
Very nice, very nice. Simon Brown said, I noticed that the rhythm and the backing appear to be done on the swell volume there. Very good.
Yeah, well spotted.
Have Wersi given an option to separate the backing from the swell? Many,
absolutely,
many, many, many versions ago. But yes, you can, yeah, you can. The actual swell pedal setting area is quite a, that's a video in itself, isn't it?
Yes, well, we've done a video on Patreon on all of that.
Thank you very much.
Hey. But it's an interesting thing, actually. I've always tried to pin Ulrich down as to,
yeah,
why German organs have this philosophy. So the philosophy is in the German organs is that the rhythm section or the style and the accompaniment are not affected by the expression pedal, or they are very slightly affected.
Yeah, yeah.
And it's funny, if you look at old videos of all the Wersi players from years ago, I remember watching them always reaching over to the side.
Yeah, and adjusting.
They were adjusting, continually adjusting the volume of the accompaniment to match how they were playing up here. And I was like, wow, it just seems strange. So when I first sat down and played a Wersi, I was like, well, that seems a bit weird. But obviously it was the standard practice in Germany.
Practice in Germany, yeah.
But in my mind, it kind of makes more sense for it to go up and down with the expression pedal.
Yeah.
So it is actually a very simple thing to change. We go, I know we haven't got one on the screen on
here. No.
But if you do pop on Patreon, there's a video on this where we go into detail.
Absolutely.
But you can go into the accompaniment settings, and there are basically four boxes here for the accompaniment parts. So there's the sounds of the accompaniment, the drum part, the real drums, if you're using real drums. I mean, that style there, actually. One of the reasons why that sounds so good is that's real drums.
Ah,
real drummer.
Real drums. Fresh
and multimedia, which is for things like your audio and MIDI files when they're playing them back. And so for all of those, you can choose what they call, and this is a bit technical, an expression pedal curve. and the curve basically decides how much the expression pedal affects the volume. And I've got them all set on basically a straight curve.
Not a hyperbolic curve?
Not a straight curve, which would technically be called a line.
Whoa, back up a bit.
No, get a bit technical. and so when I put my foot down, the drums and stuff go up and down with my foot, essentially.
Got it.
And once you've made that change, you can make it so that it is the standard setting for the organ. So next time you turn it on, that's how it's always going to be.
Understood.
But very well spotted. I'm
that's
impressed. Yeah.
Very good, Simon. Yeah. Excellent. We have, after that, Peter Smith asking how Sybil is. Keith Darville. Hello, Keith. Looking forward to both keep talking. Tom and Trevor listening to you both. Okay, good.
Okay.
In the dark. Ken D, greetings from Central Florida, where it is sunny. Sorry, it's always sunny there. The Wersi sounds beautiful over YouTube. I can only imagine how it sounds in the room.
Yeah, I mean...
Oh, now, that is a point about hearing a Wersi 900, isn't it?
Yeah, the Wersi 900 does use external speakers.
It does.
So you can either choose to use the Vocalis speakers or the Tower speakers.
TS-9000s.
There was only the 9000s that can be done in a matching colour.
Yes. Vocalis, yeah.
But yeah, it sounds incredible. I mean, it's actually funny enough, when we play it through here through the headphones, it sounds gorgeous as well.
Yeah, absolutely.
And I know, I mean, we kind of complain about YouTube and saying the sound quality and so forth, but actually,
it's still
YouTube actually is
very
good. High bit rate, and it's high definition videos as well. So if you watch this with a pair of headphones on, or you're watching it through your TV system with your cinema surround sound system, you are getting a pretty good sound. It used to be that, you know, when you watched things on the internet, the sound would be rubbish. And it'd be very tinny, and your computer wouldn't have very good speakers. But nowadays,
sorry, I just realised what Alan Sleep was saying over. He said the second hand Wersi referred to the Lurch segment. That's what he means, a second hand Wersi. That was very good, Alan. Very good. Yes, that was too clever for us. Yes, I mean, you know, I could say I've got to hand it to him. Hey. Anyway,
I haven't got a.
No, you haven't, have you? I'll do. Keys has said, what version of the software is the OX900 running?
2.9.
That is the latest software.
Yeah. Yeah. There's nothing slightly hangering on that we've got.
No. Is Trevor actually playing against sheet music? That has to be a first. Winky smile.
Yes.
Yes.
Because I couldn't remember the Bond themes.
Simon Brown says, if.
And it's easy to play as well.
It is. Simon Brown says, if Wersi offer wood veneer on their instruments now, would they offer this on the new 900 as an option?
Yeah. Yeah.
New 900 available in wood veneer. What colours do they do, Trevor? Is it just mahogany?
Again, I think it's generally mahogany, but if you had a specific request, they would try their best. And of course, there would be an additional charge.
Yeah. Okay. So. Mahogany, brown thing, yes. Douglas
Watts,
wooden coloured. Would Wersi consider a music rest similar to the Ringway RS1000, virtually full length of the organ? Well, yes and no. I think the thing is, they would say, well, digitise your sheet music and put it in the organ. Because there is an option to import sheet music into the instrument and then bring it up on the screen.
Yeah, I mean, if you really wanted a long range, a full range one, you could get a piece of Perspex made.
Yeah.
That was the width of the organ, because you can get companies to make Perspex for you.
That's right, yeah.
If they cut the lip to this size, so it would fit in the hole, but it would be longer, because most of the time if you're using the full range music desk, it's mainly because you've got photocopied music to put across the whole width of the organ rather than books. So you can still have a book in the middle, and if you've got extra bits on there, you could do, yes.
Yes. But of course now, something we've noticed at Peterborough, at our Music Extravaganza show, which we need to talk about that, haven't we? Is that so many now people who are playing the organ are using a tablet, like an iPad, and they've got all their music in a program. So the thing of having lots of sheets on a music rest is almost becoming...
Yeah, I was impressed actually at Peterborough, how many people had it all done.
Yeah.
Because I'm very lazy, I still don't.
Sue King, hello Sue and David.
Hello Sue.
Is it right I can have 6 sounds together on each Lowry keyboard?
No. Go on Tom, I'll let you do those ones.
Okay. So,
see if you can add these up.
Right. So you can have on the top keyboard, you can have orchestral 1 and 2. You can have solo 1 and 2. You can have the upper sounds or the upper genius, and then another sound section, if you like, is the tabs. So in theory, you can have 6 quote unquote voices together. But obviously, you then don't have a split point sound, because obviously you can't have any one of the sounds obviously ported down. So because we tend to sort of think of the sounds on the Lowry, the drawbars, the tabs, the strings, the theatre things. The tabs are like a sound section in their
That's
own right.
Right.
Yeah. So how did I do there, Trevor?
Did I make it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Very good. Graham Williams said, if you want to output a manual and pedal keyboard to the same MIDI channel and set it up as a user preset, you cannot use this on both the keyboard and the pedals. What am I missing?
Yeah, you can't have the same MIDI channel because the way the Wersi handles MIDI is it's set up as an actual voice.
Yeah.
And the software gets cross with you if you try and have the same MIDI channel being broadcast by the same keyboards.
Mm.
So if you set up a voice that transmits on channel 1, you can't have that same voice on the lower keyboard.
No.
Because to be honest, I'm not sure what situation you'd want them to be merged, because in my mind, most of the time you always want them separately so that you can differentiate between the what you're doing on the upper and what you're doing on the lower.
Yes.
Whereas if you had them all on channel 1, then they would just be a jumble, as it were.
Absolutely. Mini's good fun to mess around with.
I must admit, with organs, I know we put expanders and organs and things, but one of the nice things about organs is the fact that you do have it all here in front of you.
Mm. Absolutely. Andrew Clifford from Horncastle. Hello, Andrew. He's thoroughly enjoying the live feed, loves the red colour, and looking forward to getting his 900 in the near future.
Oh, yeah.
Yes. Yes. Absolutely. So that will be exciting. Babs Wallace says, lots of love to Sybil from our precious old pussycat, Izzy.
Oh, lovely. Thank you.
Keith Darville. P.S. Tom, my organ has 12-foot pedals on it, which is far enough for me. Can you get the same on Wersi organs? 12-foot pedals. Well, 12 would be...
One octave.
No, 13 would be an octave.
We probably missed out the one at the end.
Probably missed out the one at the end, yes. Yeah, most of the... most organs have at least a minimum of 13 pedals. The 500 has a 17 pedal board, as does the 600.
Yeah.
The 700, 800, 900, and Pergamon 1000 has a 25 note large pedal board. I mean, it's one of those things. People always used to say, you know, an octave is enough. And the reason organ manufacturers used to make and use octave pedals because they were just a standard thing that they could manufacture or buy from a pedal board maker. But it was always nice to have the extra. I remember on Yamaha. My Yamaha organ when I was a kid learning to play, the thing of having the extra half octave at the end was you could go up the walking bass sort of pattern and then go above to top D and E. So musically, having more than an octave, maybe not 25 pedals, is always a very good
idea. Funnily enough, I've done a lot of videos actually on that because...
Have you?
Yeah.
Have you really? But where are these videos, Trevor?
Where could you find them? Because it's a bit of it's something that annoys me a little bit about 13 note pedal boards and organs is because you can't move the bass part how it should be.
No.
Because you're limited to just one D, for example.
Exactly.
So if the music needs a D bass, you've only got one to play.
Yeah. And how's the therapy going?
Yeah, I know. Yes. and so if you're playing, I mean, literally the piece of music I was just playing there has a wonderful sort of descending bass.
Yes.
I'll turn down a bit.
Hello.
So you can hear the bass is going. So it's going down, and it's a lovely movement.
It is.
In the bass.
Really pretty.
Whereas if I was trying to do that in one octave, I'd get a.
Yeah, it's not a normal
get this
movement.
Rather than the da-da-da-da. And that's the big thing. So if we've got just a few extra pedals, like the 17-note pedal board that the 500 has, you could start that piece with the D up here, and then that can move down.
C-sharp. And actually, on the screen now, we have the bass display, don't we?
Yeah.
Check you're playing the right pedals.
But that makes such a difference because that bass line can now move the way it's supposed
to. It's a proper musical movement.
Because most of the time bass lines tend to move like that. They rise up and they rise down. They don't do lots of big jumps.
A descending scalic movement.
Yeah.
Thank you very much. So Keith, if you don't have more than so Keith, phone us.
Yes.
We will
make good use of just a couple of extra pedals.
Yes.
Because it means that you're not always jumping up and down and you've got a different note to play depending on the piece of music.
Absolutely. Yes. Absolutely.
So big thing.
We would like to welcome Valerio Cecchi from Italy.
Wow.
Buongiorno, that's what we say, isn't it? Yes, there we go. And he says, greetings to Mr. Trevor and Mr. Tom. Lovely to see the Wersi organ. I was wondering, is the Lowry brand still in production?
No.
Sadly, no more Lowry's.
I'd say it would have been about 4 years now, isn't it?
It must be getting on for 4 years, since Kawhi, the owner of Lowry, stopped producing.
Decided to cease production.
Yeah. And that's more or less what's happened, really. There's nothing more than that. It's just there's just no more Lowry's. But fortunately, we here in the UK have lots of lovely pre-loved Lowry's, which come and go.
And because they're still
supporting.
Supporting them, then there's no issue with them, yeah.
No, absolutely. So so we still retail a huge range of pre-owned Lowry's, and obviously they all come guaranteed with all the bits and pieces, owner's guides and things. So they're still very much, along with Wersi and Lowry, a massive
and
part
Ringway,
of our Ringway of what yeah. we of our stable. Peter Brown, one question for a future Wersi Wonders.
Hey,
can you give some guidance to the reverb programming section?
Yeah,
there you go. Sorted.
I'll try and do it without referring to condiments.
Yes. Sue King said, I made a long music rest from cardboard and covered it with wallpaper to match the room.
There we go. Camouflaged.
Where's the organ? Don't worry, I'll use this one.
Camouflage music. That's a great
absolutely.
Idea. Yeah, I love that.
Ian Ship says, it sounds good, not sure about the colour. Yeah, yeah, red's
it's a personal choice.
It's a personal
yeah.
choice. Yeah. But as you say, it's available in the black, the pearlescent white. Other colours are available for an extra premium because they're special order, as is the mahogany wood.
I want somebody to order a yellow one. I think yellow would be great.
Do you know what I think would be good? Is a gold organ.
Ooh.
An actual golden, proper yeah. metallic key sparkly.
Well, they
gold.
Do a metallic brown, don't they?
Yes, a metallic brown, that's an option, yes. Actually, Keith Rose, he's got a metallic brown, well, they're very nice. So, Douglas Ross says, is there a Patreon video on how to load up music scores into the Wersi?
Not yet.
but
there will be.
But there will be soon. Absolutely. Steve Homan, Nigel has an extra long music stand made and has the Wersi logo engraved.
There
yes.
you go, yeah, it can be done.
Nigel, I think, knows a man who does car spraying and stuff, he's got contacts, Nigel.
Got contacts.
There you go. But we actually have Lowry Perspexes made
yeah,
for us.
Made, yeah.
We've had them done for Symphony Showcase and Prestige Plus and so on. Graham Williams says, I've managed it, but it's not straightforward. Oh, the MIDI thing, yeah. Mm.
Yeah.
Scott Phillips, trying to get comfortable with my Sterling. Well, try sit on the bench, that would help. maybe a cushion, Scott, yeah. But it's great to hear what the Wersi can do. Keep up your fantastic work for us hobby
the
players.
The Sterling edition actually was lovely organ.
It was lovely.
I presume it's in America, because there's not many Sterlings
I would probably
UK,
say,
yeah.
Maybe. Yeah. Scott, are you USA? Mm. Hopefully. Yeah, it's all good. But yes, I remember the launch of the Sterling. That was the first one of the
silver panel.
The silver panel. It was the later yeah. A series, mm. Superseded by the limited edition Symphony and the Patriot in America.
Yeah.
And then, of course, we had the Liberty, and then in recent times, the Symphony Showcase edition. Simon Brown, I did wonder, he said, how flexible Wersi might be for someone who wanted an instrument that would have two 76-note keyboards as the new 900 does, but would prefer the smaller 17-note pedal board. Ah.
We have already had one of those made.
I had an 800 yeah. made with a 600
Ulrich,
pedal board.
It was a bit of a challenge for them, but they made... it would probably be easier on this one because there's no built-in speakers to worry about.
Yeah.
But yeah, that's a fantastic thing that Wersi are. We went to Wersi and said we had a customer who wanted an 800.
Didn't have room for the pedals.
Didn't want the full pedal board, wanted a regular pedal board. And they made one with a 17-note pedal board.
Yeah.
So yeah, can be done.
I remember delivering it and he was over the moon with it.
Yeah,
and it played very well. So yeah.
Can be done. I would say it's probably easier for them to do it on a 900 because you haven't got the speakers.
Yes,
in the way.
That's yeah. right. Yeah. So, So Simon, get in touch. We'll talk. Scott Phillips is from subtle. Scott Phillips is from Orlando, Florida.
Oh, there we go. Yeah.
He may possibly have already mentioned that.
A bit of plug, but we do make some wonderful software for the.
We
Sterling
do.
Edition.
We do. In fact, what I'm going to do, in a smoother silk move, I'm going to type into the link our Lowry software. Pack link, because we have actually got this year some new one or two new packs coming, haven't
we,
Trevor?
Absolutely. But there's already so many out that make such a difference.
There you go, Scott. Just there for you, sir. We've got loads available for the Sterling. We can either post the stick with the booklet. If you're able to download them onto the stick and print your own booklet, it saves a lot on the postage, obviously. But there's some lovely registrations, and many of those videos have been featured on YouTube demos and on Patreon as well. Do you know, Trevor, we have got up to 113 viewers today.
Wow, that's incredible.
In fact, we are currently at 113.
Wow.
That is quite something. Quite something, yeah. Absolutely. So it's absolutely beautiful. Really is.
How are we doing for time?
It is 10 to 4.
Yeah.
I know, yes.
That's a nice tune.
I wasn't actually playing on this one. I was just fiddling.
Yeah,
Dean Martin.
Because I was just... the registrations were playing this.
Yes. That was part of your Christmas thing.
I do love having this great guitar.
But the nylon guitar.
Yeah.
Lovely sound.
I'm doing a bit of preset roulette here because I can't remember what I did.
Only one way to find out.
Yeah. See if there's anything number three. Oh, there is. Songs today that just have fade outs.
Very nice. I like
it. So, do you want to do
yes.
the announcement?
I will, yes.
Because that's very,
this
very
is,
important.
This is big. Since last week, when I was told by Jill, who said that the priority booking will be finished on Tuesday, I got muddled up with which Tuesday it is. So we always have a thing where we
there's
like
a few
to
choose from.
Indeed, yeah. So the folks who come to the show, we like to give them the option to, you know, rebook their place, rebook the same room that they were in.
Come again, yes.
Come again, as it were, as a little thing. And then, of course, we let it go on general public release. So as of the end of today, all the bedrooms that we've got, but we've actually already pre-booked additional rooms this year, will be released. So as of the end of today, if you came last year and are still thinking, oh, I need to everything will go public as of tomorrow. Amazingly, I spoke to Jill earlier. She's doing very well. She's actually had a little bit of an operation, actually, so she's sort of slowly recovering from that, but she's doing okay. And I know she's been speaking to a lot of you regarding Music Extravaganza 2023. Mm-hmm. But the show is now over half booked already.
Wow, that's incredible.
This is just I said to her, I said, you're messing around, Jill. Yeah. I said, oh, you must.
That's absolutely brilliant. So if you want to come, which is an awesome, fantastic
really
weekend.
Is. Yes, we're there, aren't we? You know,
what do you want to get to see us live?
But this year we've got Brett Wales, Claudia Hirschfeld, Claire Grieg, Trevor Flunder, yeah. Tom Horton. It's also just I know we always bang on about
this. At the end of the list, I just noticed.
I just thought I'd go second to last for a change. You see, yeah, it's called reverse alphabetical order.
Right, I got top billing at the end.
You did. That's right, save the best till last. What do you want? Anyway, I'm going to turn your microphone off. There you go. Anyway, but it's at the four-star, it's a Marriott hotel. They call it now Delta Hotels by Marriott, but it's the four-star Marriott at Peterborough. But it is a fully inclusive accommodation. So breakfast, lunch, three-course evening meal, tea and coffee in between the workshops and things. So everything's included. Evening concerts where we have the cameras and the lights and everything. Daytime tuition workshops, not on just how Wersi, Ringway and Lowry organs were, but there's musical workshops as well.
It was a beautiful hotel, lots of fun events during the afternoon, one-to-one support sessions. We get to see all the latest Wersi, Ringway and Lowry organs. And the nicest thing about the whole event for us is that everyone who comes is all like-minded. We're all there because we all love our organs and we love this wonderful journey and hobby of music that we're all on. So I put the link in there, but just go to the website allensmusiccentre.co.uk. The booking form, the brochure is on there now with the menus. And of course Douglas Watch, very excited. You didn't mention Lucy. Yes, Lucy will be there. Com will be there. Tam will be there.
Jill.
Everyone. Jill. Yes, I was coming to that. Yeah. loads and loads of people.
No Sybil,
yes.
Though.
Hang on. Yes. Sorry, Douglas. I got it. No Sybil. No. And it's quite lovely. It really is. And we love seeing everyone there. But we know some folks sometimes wait till a bit later in the year to book. But it is going.
Yeah.
Absolutely
it's not normally the case that we're this so booked up
no,
so quickly.
No.
If you are thinking about it, it's getting there quick.
It's getting there quick, absolutely. Says Simon Brown says, I can see Wersi for me are leading the way, add the potential of a Lowry VST in the future, and this becomes an amazing home organ.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Absolutely. David Woods has asked, can we know the price, please?
So we haven't actually just worked out the price yet,
no.
Because we haven't just got it.
Yeah.
But I know if you send us an email, we can work it out for you.
Absolutely, absolutely. Because also, as Trevor said, there's all variations with colour and things. David says, in Penzance, thank you Tom and Trevor for another entertaining and informative session. Somebody once said I had a good face for radio.
Yeah.
I must say that Wersi, the Wersi does look massive, isn't it? Bracket, please don't phone me, Tom, I haven't got the room. It's all right, Tam's... David in Penzance. Yes, it's all right. But Tam has got a big hammer, David. Tam has got a big hammer. So absolutely. So it's wonderful. Yeah, so as I say, do as soon as you can book up for Peterborough. We will say, I think we're there, Travis.
Oh, we're
4 o'clock.
Oh.
Thank you so much for watching, everyone. 121 viewers.
Wow, that's a record.
That is a record.
That's even more than we get at Peterborough.
Yes, absolutely. What are you going to finish with, Trevor?
A bit of Conquest of Paradise.
Excellent. Very good. Love to see you all, folks. See you next time.